You are listening to Radio Yestaraga. You are tuned into the leading internet radio station in the mother city.
Our station, our talent, our people.
Die ding rukkie.
Well, then we're going to sing us some Jamaican songs. But if we sing them, you got to get out of those seats and you got to dance like you're really from Jamaica. Or your parents were from Jamaica, parents' parents were from Jamaica. But I want you to be true to who you are. Someday, come on, everybody say,
I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus someday.
I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back,
because I want to see my Jesus someday.
They say this, goodbye world. Come on, say it again. Say it.
Yeah. be saying,
oh, I want to see him look upon his face, then to sing forever of the saving grace. On those streets of the glory, let me lay my voice. All my cares are past, home at last, ever to rejoice. I'ma say it again, yes, I want to see him, gonna look upon his face. There to sing forever, Lord, of the saving grace. Oh, the streets of glory, let me lift my voice.
Yes, I do, yes, I do.
My mind made up, and I won't turn back, because I want to see my Jesus
someday. Oh, my. Fire, fire, fire. Fire, fall on me. Sit down.
Fire, fire, fire. Fire, fall on me.
Just that on the day.
The number one internet radio station.
I'm at work right now and I'm listening to it.
Number one for classic hits.
Good afternoon, greetings listeners, greeting family and friends. Wow, it's Wednesday afternoon. And yeah, we are back with our new life hour. But first, let me say that we are live on the Radio East River, who is the leading internet radio station in Cape Town. There are many different ways to stream our shows, catch us live on Facebook on the Radio East River page, and also join our YouTube live on the Radio East River channel. Like the video and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and also visit our website for the live stream and get to know more about Radio East River. You can find us at www.radioeastriver.co.za. And then, of course, the best way to experience Radio East River is to download the Radio East River app. This is available to download for free on any and all smart devices. So download our app on Play Store, Y Gallery and App Store. And of course, our WhatsApp line is 064-536-9095. And as we always say, die ding ruk hierso en vanmiddag, wil ek sê in Afrikaans dat die ding gaan ruk hier op Eerste River, Radio Eerste River, because we are live and this is your new live radio hour. My name is Ricardo and wow, I am excited to be here this afternoon. I'm looking forward to the show this afternoon. Maybe the time is going to be too little for the program this afternoon. And like I said, for those who don't know me, my name is Ricardo. I hail from the Northern Cape. I hail from Upington. Ek is in die Makwalandse kind vir die mense daar in Steinkopf. Ek weet nie of julle online is, maar ek wil vir julle ook vanmiddag groet. En man, ek is so excited vir hierdie program vanmiddag. And so yeah, but let us start. We're going to have a lekker full program. I'm only going to play 2 or 3 songs today, because I want to speak about what, you know, about what we've started last week and the week before. And as I've said in the beginning, this is a new show. And man, the show's name is New Life Hour. So I'm going to speak about new life today. And I'm going to speak from this new life that is from the Bible. We started the show with, you know, the whole, I call it the divine dialogue between Nicodemus and Jesus. And, you know, in that dialogue that Nicodemus and Jesus had, Jesus pointed out or he responded with something very significant. And I'm not going to speak about Nicodemus and Jesus today. I'm just going back to where we have started with the show. And Jesus said in his response to Nicodemus that, man, you have to be born of the water and you have to be born of the Spirit. And you cannot enter the kingdom of God without being born again. Basically, Jesus was saying that you cannot enter his kingdom. You cannot go into the kingdom without receiving new life. The Bible says that when we are in Christ, who is the giver of life, who is the author of life, if we don't have him, man, then we are lost. But I want to say the Bible says that when we are in Christ, we are a new creation. And today I want to speak about this brand new life that we can have in Christ. It's going to be awesome. I'm going to go into a story again in the Bible, and I'm going to speak about three stories. But the main focus will be on one story. And I know that today's show or today's program, that something will happen with some people who's listening to this afternoon. And I wanna encourage you to keep your seats ready and keep your seats tight. And man, after the break, we're gonna start with this show today. And I wanna theme the show that your coffin is gonna open up today. If you have a coffin, and you might not understand it right now, but if there's a coffin in your life that is closed, it's going to open up today. Man, there's going to be some resurrection power that is going to flow this afternoon. So we're going to go for a quick break. And then when we come back, man, I'm going to just quickly share with you what I believe the New Life Hour is going to be about today.
You are tuned into the leading internet radio station in the mother city.
Some days life feels perfect, other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing, we can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable, broken, live or die. So speak life, speak life, to the deadest, darkest night. Speak life, speak life, when the sun won't shine and you don't know why. Look into the eyes of the brokenhearted, watch them come alive as soon as you speak hope, you speak love. It's twisted, other days my thoughts just fall apart. I do, I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life. Fire, hope will fall like rain. You speak life with the words you say.
say, raise your thoughts a little higher.
Hey there, music lovers. Looking for a place to find all your music needs? Well, look no further than Tom's, the heart of music. At our Tom's Heritage Square and Belleville stores, you can shop guitars, drums and percussion, studio and home recording equipment, pro audio and DJ equipment, pianos and keyboards. We're also the Western Cape's only authorized dealers of Gibson and Epiphone guitars. Come visit us at 65 Clayton Crux Street, Heritage Square, Cape Town, or 92 Edward Street, Tiger Valley, Belleville, and let our friendly and knowledgeable staff help you find what you need.
Yes,
our station, our talent, our people.
Die ding rukkie.
Good afternoon once again, listeners. Greetings, family. Yes, we are back at... We are back live and we are on Radio Eesterhuwe and this is waar die ding mos ruk, man. Ons gaan nou vanmiddag gou gesels, ons wil gou vinnig gesels oor die program. This is your new life hour, this is Ricardo. And yes, we are speaking about life, we are speaking about new life, this is your new life hour. And man, I want to quickly go into the show for this afternoon. And man, let me rather start because before I run before me, let me start. I want to share with you quickly a story in the Bible. And this is where, you know, the story in Luke. Luke 7 verse 11, a short story, but it's a life story. And like I said, this is your new life hour. So we speak about life. And this new life that we speak about, this new life comes from Jesus Christ. And therefore, we have to consider the Bible when we speak about new life. Jesus said to Nicodemus, you have to be born again before you can enter the kingdom of God. And we all know, when we speak about the word born, it means that the word born is related to life. And now Jesus comes and he says to Nicodemus, but you have to be born again. And man, the born again life is the new life that we are talking about. And man, this is going to be this theme that I have for this afternoon. It's about life. Let me share Luke 7, 11 to 17. And this is, the story goes like this in the Bible. Now it happened the day after that he went into a city called Nain. The story speaks about Jesus going into a city called Nain. And many of his disciples went with him. And with them, this is now with Jesus and with his disciples, there was a large crowd, says the Bible. And then it goes on and it says, and when they came near the city or near the gate of the city, behold, a dead man was being carried out, who was the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. And a large crowd from the city was with her. Now you need to get the picture here. It's like Jesus and his disciples. And you know, they, with them there was a large crowd. And then as they approach the city gate, this is now near the city of Nain. And by the way, Nain, the significance of Nain is, it speaks about the fact that it was a beautiful place. It speaks about the fact that, you know, it was in a pleasant place that, you know, that where Jesus and his disciples and that large crowd were going to. But you see, as they going into this city called Nain, so Jesus goes with his crowd, and then out of the city, you know, comes another crowd with a mother, and this is like a funeral procession. So, you know, in the, you know, in the, on the rural area, daar waar ek vanaf kom, gaan, as jy sien, hulle gaan uit, they going out and they take the funeral to the outskirts of the place or of the city in order to obviously to lay the dead to rest. And now, Jesus and his disciples and his and their crowd, they are approached by a funeral procession. And there was a widow and a large crowd from the city was with her. And the Bible says, when the Lord saw this widow, he had compassion on her. And he said to her, do not cry, do not weep. And then Jesus did something interesting. So it's like Jesus saw this woman. And the way how Jesus was always, you know, he observed something, he noticed something, he noticed the things that we don't normally notice. He noticed some stuff that we don't normally see. And he saw, you know, the Bible says when the Lord saw her, this is when Jesus saw her, he had compassion on her. And he said to her specifically, do not cry. It's almost like Jesus was saying to her, your cry is over. And I want to say to someone today, you see, we are speaking about life today. And I want to say today to someone, your tears are over. Your cries, it's time to stop crying. It's time to speak. You see, because you are hearing the word of life today. It's the new life hour. So we are speaking about life today. And Jesus is saying to this woman, it's time to stop crying. I want to say to someone today, stop crying. Stop weeping. Irrespective, no matter what the circumstances are. Because you see, when Jesus, who is the author of life, when Jesus, who is the giver of life, when he comes and interrupts certain things, then you see the weeping stop. In fact, the weeping, let me put it this way, let me submit it to you. The weeping must stop when the Lord Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith and who is the author and the giver of life, when he comes and he divinely interrupts your life, then things must change. And therefore, this woman's situation changed drastically when Jesus spoke to her to say, do not weep. And then, like I said, Jesus did something interesting. The Bible says he came and he touched the open coffin, and those who carried him stood still. Now you must imagine, you see, when there's a funeral procession, in normal circumstances, you know, you are not allowed to just come and do things and speak things and come and do some crazy stuff. But Jesus here, he came and he touched the open coffin after he said to this woman, do not weep. And those, the Bible says, those who carried him, they stood still. They became stationary. And then Jesus said, young man, I say to you, arise. Young man, I say to you, rise up. And so he who was dead, the Bible says, listen to this. So he who was dead, sat up and he began to speak. And then Jesus presented him to his mother. Verse 16 says, and then fear came upon all and they glorified God, saying, a great prophet has risen amongst us and God has visited his people. Man, what a powerful scripture. What a powerful portion of scripture. What I want to say to someone today, what I want to bring out in the show today, like I said, we are speaking about new life. Man, this young boy, and I mean, I'm just saying he's a young boy because the Bible says, Jesus says, his words were specifically young men. I say to you, arise. So that means this man or this young man, he was dead. He was mors dood. He was absolutely dead. And then Jesus came on the scene. And he interrupts this whole funeral procession. And he says to this man, rise up. I say to you, rise up. Can you hear what I'm trying to say? So let me rephrase it and put it this way. Jesus come and he sees this whole funeral procession that's happening. And it's a funeral, it's a procession of death. And what is interesting, there were two crowds. And you see, the one crowd represented death. The other crowd represented life. Because the crowd of life who was with Jesus, they now came and they are approached by this crowd of death. And Jesus said to this woman, woman, you see what's going to happen now. You have to stop weeping. You have to stop crying. Because I, who is the author of life, I'm saying to you, there's a brand new time for you starting right now. It's a brand new day that's starting for you right now. Because you see, the Bible tells us that this widow, she was actually in sorrow. She had loss. And Jesus observed that in the spirit, that she had such a loss because this was her only son. And her husband already died. So which means this woman was now obviously alone in this world. When they were going to bury this boy or this man, this young man, she was going to be alone. And Jesus observed in the spirit that she had such a sorrow and such a loss. And that the circumstance was not favorable. And man, Jesus decided and said to her, it's time for you to stop weeping. It's time for you to stop crying. It's time for you to stop looking at your natural circumstances. And I'm saying to someone today, it's time for you to stop weeping. Maybe there's a mother out there, in the same way this woman was there. Maybe there's a mother right now who's crying. You have such loss. You have sorrow in your life. Today is a brand new day. Today is a new day. Today is the day of life that's going to come into your circumstances, that's going to come into your situation. And the giver and the author of life is saying unto you, stop weeping because a new day has dawned for you. And you see, Jesus goes on and he speaks to this coffin. This coffin, the Bible describes it as an open coffin. And he says, young man, I say to you, arise. You see, the Bible records the fact that Jesus actually, you know, there was basically three people besides this young man that Jesus rose from the dead. There was three other people. It was this young boy, and then it was Jairus' daughter also. And then also, it was our friend Lazarus. In fact, Jesus' friend. And I call it our friend because we all know the story about Lazarus. I want to say to us today, you see, if you want to have a new life, the Bible says in John 11 verse 25, and I can read it for us. John 11 25 says this. It says, and this is Jesus speaking here, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this? I want to ask the question today before we go to another song break. I want to ask someone the question today. Do you believe this? What I'm sharing with you, what I'm speaking to you this afternoon. If a young man was in his coffin already, if Jesus can come in and raise him from the death, man, I'm telling you, in Jesus, there's new life. I am telling you, because Jesus himself is the word of life. And when we embrace and when we receive the life that he offers unto us, we can receive new life. The new life that we can have is only available in and through Christ. Because when we are in Christ, the Bible says, and this is a true statement, when we are in Christ, we are a new creature. You see, when this young man, when he stood up after Jesus spoke to him, it was almost like the Bible did not leave this part out. In order to tell us and to make sure, it's almost like to verify the fact that this man in fact stood up out of death. The Bible says this in verse 15. So he who was dead sat up. He sat up first. So you see, he sat up first. And then something amazing happens. He began to speak. Man, I'm telling you, when Jesus raised something, then things began to, you know, things began to rise up. And even things will start to start speaking. So I'm telling you today that there's something that's going to happen as you listen to this program, to the show this afternoon. I strongly believe that there's going to be a divine intervention. There's going to be a divine interruption in whatever you're going through right now. And I want to declare that, and I want to decree that, because we are speaking the word of life. That's why I played that song, Speak Life. And I want to speak life into certain situations and circumstance today. In the same way that Jesus came and said to this woman, it's time to stop weeping. It's time to consider that life is in front of you. I'm coming with, my crowd is a crowd of life. So get out from that crowd of death. And I know, you know, I'm speaking to someone today also. How long do you want to be behind the crowd of death? It's time to get out of the crowd of death and get behind the crowd of life. We're going to go for a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to open some spiritual coffins.
Our station, our talent, and our people.
Chosen generation, we've been called for to show His excellence. Hey, all I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation, we've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, for I know who I am. I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am, I know who God says I am, what He says I am, where He says I'm at. I know who I am. I'm walking in power, I'm working miracles, I live a life of favor. Chosen generation, we've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. Come, we've been called for to show His excellence. All I require for life, God has given me.
says I'm mad. I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I walk in miracles. I live a life of life. For I know who I am. I'm walking in power. I walk in miracles. I live a life of favor. For I know who I am. Everybody shout. Oh, 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 I know who I am. Lift your voice.
Buying a new home? Look no further than Central Blue in Blue Downs. Choose from freestanding homes, townhouses, duplexes, and apartments. Contact us today. Visit our website at centralblue.co.za. Call us on 087-096-0962 or send us an email at sales@centralblue.co.za. Safe and quality lifestyle at affordable prices.
Radio Estrofie, Didang Rekki.
Didang Rekki, so greetings everybody, greetings family and friends, greeting friends, unknown friends as well. Ons sê altyd, man, groet sommer jou enemies en jou frenemies en allemaal die mense wat inluister. Family and friends, man, I am so, I know that something must happen this afternoon with someone. And we are speaking about, this is your new life hour, live on Radio Easter River, this waar die ding ruk. And I'm just going to continue with a few things in from our text that I've read in Luke 7. And I want to continue, and there's a few minutes left. And today I'm going to do a bit, you know, I'm going to be a bit different today, especially in the end with the show. Because as the show develops, I also want to say there will be some guests in the field. There was supposed to be a guest today, But yeah, circumstance didn't allow it. But obviously, our special guest, the Holy Spirit, is always here. And you see, when you have this new life that I'm talking about, and remember, this is the new life hour. When you have this new life that I am talking about, then you know, something brand new happens to you as well. And that brand new thing is the fact that you are possessed by the Holy Spirit. And those that don't know about it, man, when you get this new life in Christ, when you become a new creature, then you receive the Holy Spirit who will possess you. He will not only fill you, he will possess you because you will be baptized by him. That's part of the new life. And that's why I said even in the first program, when you receive new life, it's a brand new life. The old is gone and the new has come. It's a complete new life. And today I'm speaking about how Jesus raised up a young man, because the Bible calls him, when Jesus spoke to him, Jesus said, young man, rise up. And I'm speaking about how Jesus raised somebody from the death. And I said also that Jesus raised Jairus' daughter also from the death. And Jesus also raised Lazarus from the death, as many of us would know. So Jesus is the giver of life. He is the author of life. And he gives us life. And very importantly, he not only gives us life, but he gives us new life. If I go back to what he said to Nicodemus, we have to be born again. And that born again means that we have to receive new life. So Nicodemus asked the question, how can a man go back into his mother's womb when he's in his old age? And then Jesus explained to him that he must be born of the water and of the Spirit. So this born again concept means that we have to receive a new life. So we already have been born. But now Jesus is saying to us, we have to be born again. And we will still deal with the story, why, the reason why we need to be born again. There's a reason why we need to be born again. And that's for another show, when we speak about the kingdom of God and how we need to enter into the kingdom of God. Because there's a reason why we have to be born again. Because Jesus restored our kingdom status. Jesus restored our life, our true life status in God that we once had. And now we have it back when we receive this new life in Christ. Man, Jesus raised up this young man. And I said, when Jesus stood with his crowd, he came with the crowd of life and he approached death. And you see, when Jesus, who is the author of life, when he comes and he stands in front of death, then you see death must stop. Because you see, the Bible says when when Jesus approached them, it's like they stood still, because the Bible specifically said, when Jesus came and touched the open coffin, and those who carried him, they stood still. You see, when life comes in front of death, death must stop. And that is why Jesus said to this woman, stop weeping, stop crying, because I'm bringing you life. I'm bringing you life today. And today you will see how life happened in front of you. And not only life, but new life. Today your cry is over. Today your tears will stop. Because I'm going to show you what I can do. And I want to encourage somebody today that when we receive Jesus, then we can rely on the fact that our life will completely change. It will change from the inside out. I shared a bit of my testimony, I think, in the first program. So I can confidently be a witness to the true fact, to the truth, that when Jesus comes on the scene and when he interrupts your life, then things has to change. It must change. You see, this situation that presented itself here with this woman who was so full of sorrow, who was so deeply sorrowed and so who experienced this deep loss of life. Because, you see, Jesus observed in the story that she had such a loss because she already lost her husband. She already lost her son also. So it was almost like, what has she left in this life? And some of us sometimes feel that, you know, that we need to give up because we've got nothing. But you see, in Jesus, when Jesus comes on the scene, things have to change. Things have, circumstances must bow down to the giver of life. And I want to say today, before we go even into the spiritual coffins as well, you see, again, I want to put emphasis on the fact that Jesus, when he comes on your scene, and I believe he's coming on the scene for many today, because by the hearing of the word, I know that something supernatural must happen. And that's part of our new life in Christ. When we speak the word, when we share the word, something supernatural happens. And so significant, it's when even when we do it through the air, and through the airwaves and through the frequencies. You see, this word has life in it. The Bible says the word of God is alive and active. It cuts through marrow and bone. It divides joint and it divides soul and spirit. So it's alive and active. Jesus himself says, the words that I speak is life and it's spirit. So Jesus, he knows that when we hear the word, life must happen. Because where the word comes from, it comes from the very source of life. And that's when after he commanded this woman to stop weeping, he knew what he was going to do. He came and he touched the open coffin, and those who carried him stood still. You see, it's almost like when he touched the coffin, there was power that was released. Life was released. So the dead crowd couldn't move any longer because there was an interruption of life. Life came into this funeral procession and it had to stop. It had to be stationary. There was no power anymore for them to proceed any further because the power of death was stopped in its tracks. I hope you hear me. So you see, when Jesus come and touch that coffin, death could no longer move. Its capacity, its ability, the ability of death to move forward, to go to the grave, to go to the, you know, to the burial stage of this young man, to go and place him in his final resting place. It had to stop because now the giver of life, the author of life, was coming and touching that death. I want to say to somebody today, because of the power of the word, Jesus is touching somebody's life today. Jesus is touching somebody with life today. I don't know what you are weeping for, but I know that the giver of life, the one who can raise anything from death to life, he is coming today and he's saying, stop weeping, stop crying, stop complaining. It's time for circumstance to change. And then he goes further and he says, he touched the coffin. And I know that there's some coffins today that has to be touched by life. So you see, I don't know what your coffin is, your spiritual coffin. Because there's many spiritual coffins today. It can be a business idea. It can be that you feel that your finances are completely dead. It might feel that you know that your household, your marriage, whatever in your life is completely dead. It doesn't live anymore. And some of us might even feel that you know it's too late for the giver and the author of life to come and interrupt. Because you see, it's almost like in the same way where Lazarus was 4 days already, he was already in the grave. This young man was already in the coffin. They were on their way to the burial site. Jairus' daughter was already dead when, you see, Jesus was interrupted by the woman with the issue of blood. And then after he was interrupted by the woman with the issue of blood, that as he was on his way to Jairus' daughter, they said to him, there was a whole crowd also at Jairus' place. A crowd that was, the Bible says they were mourning and they were wailing and they were crying. And Jesus said to them, Jesus said to Jairus, do not listen to them. Do not fear. Only believe. Because you see, what somebody said to Jairus was this. Do not bother the teacher anymore because your daughter is already dead. Why do you bother the teacher any longer? You don't have to. And then Jesus, knowing that he is the source of life, man, he said to Jairus, do not believe what they're saying. Only believe what I'm saying. Don't listen to them. Don't even try to listen to them. And you see, I want to say to somebody today, do not listen. Do not even look to that dead circumstance, to that dead situation. Because you see, when the giver of life, Jesus, when he comes on the scene, then he comes with the source of life. Then he comes to revitalize things. Then he comes to re-energize, to energize and to transform things and to make things new and to change things completely. So whatever your spiritual coffin is today, you see, the Bible says this was a young man. And something interesting about this, the fact that it's a young man, it might be today that, you know, that there was that something in your life died prematurely. There might even be there's somebody maybe today that had an abortion. Life didn't even come. But you see, every premature spiritual death, I speak life into it today. We bring the giver of life, the word of life, the source of life into every dead situation, into every, whatever spiritual coffin you are standing or you are standing in front of today. We speak life to that. Life over every spiritual coffin. Life over every dead situation. You don't have to believe that death has taken over. You don't have to believe that. Man, the giver of life is here today. The author of life is here today. We can receive new life in Christ. Because you see, when we receive this new life in Christ, we become even a source of life unto others as well. Because when we receive this new life in Christ Jesus, man, others can receive this very same life that we have received. There's life for us today. And that life is found in Jesus Christ. That life is found in Jesus Christ. I want to do something different today. When I come back, we're going to play the new life song. This is our movement song. This is our church song. And we want to play it today because you see, we are excited about the song because the song speaks about new life. The song speaks about how we can receive new life. And today I want to play that song. And I want you to listen to that song. And when we come back after the song, I just want to speak, if I can call it this way, I want to speak a blessing of life over every household, over every individual, over every person who still follow the crowd of death, who still after the crowd of death. I want to say to someone today, it's a new day for you. I know that some, you know, that you have heard this word already. You have heard that you have to come out of death into life. It's time for you to receive new life. Listen to this song. I'm excited about this song. I will always say it. because we produced, we wrote the song and we produced the song in a space of 2-3 days. In fact, it was 2 days. Listen to the song. And then when I come back, we're going to speak live over someone today.
Revelation 21:5. Behold, I make all things new. This is the year of new things. This is the year of new life.
It's like the rapper, Ricky Kay. Yeah, new life.
Scotty C got this.
Yeah, new life, nieuwe dinge het my lewe gechange. New life, nieuwe dinge moes die vrinne replace. Van my peace, oh God, verander het van amal my ways. Uit my sone weggevat en my bevry van die pijn. Al my tranen weggevat vir hom my eer en die prijs. Was accepted by his love, but I was saving by grace. Voor ons sones gebetale, toe hy sterf van die kruis. Beter deze kan me even, though it's not for a fight. Net soos David en Goliath, sal iets aan soek slain. En al step ek in the lions, then I'll be okay. Sit my water, sit op hom, was he'll take away. My new life het ek gedraai, my leven vir hom gechange. My new life op die fondatie van die Bijbel. Anything is possible, my God is able. Walking through the valley, by die geest van God my leiding. Soos Daniel in die leeuwkel in gevaar, sal ek ook cijfers. Vraag my wat is different van my life, just see net changes. New life, I'm reborn, ek was in die duister. Gesoek om te escape van al die sonde, was ek duizelig. My nieuwe life van God en hy is die truth and video way is. Jesus Christ, in die image net soos hy is. Set your minds and things above, the old thoughts replace it. Renewing of your mind, the only way you can change it. New life, nieuwe ding.
New life, nieuwe lewe. I'm a leap by the cat, sien dat ek strewe. Let dit gaan beter, hier in my lewe. Want God het ons allemaal vergewe. Ja, dit is beter, baie beter. Ek voel nou nie meer so onzeker. Ja, want God is nou hier in my lewe. Hier in my lewe, hier in my lewe.
Ja, new life in Christ. Ek kon nie anders kiesie, was in the dark place. Ek wil nie meer een visie. Nou al leid die met ambitie en my droom een visie. Dank je vader vir die talent wat ek binnen het. Abel op my knieën, sak ek vir gebed. Sonder die kracht van die almighty kan ek glad die veeg. Ek kan glad die veeg. Humble op my knieën, sak ek vir gebed. New life, nieuwe dinge wat. New life, nieuwe dinge wat. New life, nieuwe dinge, nieuwe, nieuwe, nieuwe. New life, nieuwe dinge. New life, nieuwe dinge. Psalm 23, die Heer is my Heerde.
Niks sal my ontbreek nie, because He is the way, the truth, and the life, our new life.
Greetings, everybody. We've come to the end of our new life hour, and I just want I hope that you've heard what I was speaking about in this new life hour today. And I want to end off, and I want to say that you see, when we are in a coffin, there's limitation. When we are in a coffin, you can't move. You see, there's nothing that you can do, and even when you've died, and when something has died, there's nothing that you can do about it. But you see, there's somebody that can do something about it. And that's Jesus that we are speaking about today, who gives us new life. And so I know that there's some weeping today. I know there's some people who cries about things that have died, about situations. There's people that there's limitations. And I want to say today that everything that has died in your life, I bring the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. I bring and release the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, that life-giving power. I release it today into your situation. It's not a day to weep any longer. Maybe there's somebody that just needed to hear today. You don't have to weep anymore. You don't have to cry anymore. I'm touching your spiritual coffin today. I'm touching your life with the resurrection power that Jesus Christ gives. No more limitations. No more limitations. It's time to get behind the crowd of life. It's time to receive new life. Man, that is the end of our program today. That is the end of our show today. And Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for all the comments. Thank you for everybody that tuned in. New Life family, I greet you. I bless you. And everybody else who tuned in, I saw a few people. Man, I'm gonna get back to you. But thank you, everybody, that you for the fact that you've tuned in. Bless you all. And I bless you and I speak new life over you. We are looking forward to next week. And greetings to everybody. Your new life is here.
With a melody, you surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears have come. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Tune in to the leading internet radio station in the mother city, Radio Easter River. For more information, log on to our website, which is www.radioeasterriver.co.za.